Hello and welcome. In this tutorial, we're going to guide you through the process of converting SharePoint list items into PDF with the help of Plumsail Documents connector in PowerAutomate. We're also going to look at the special Plumsail Forms Designer tool for SharePoint. We're going to start in SharePoint with a list that we have already created, and we called it Purchase Order. As you can see, we already created all our fields. Here we can see how the default SharePoint form looks like. And later in this tutorial, we're going to customize it using Plumsail Forms Designer tool for SharePoint. Our next step will be to create or log into your Plumsail account and choose Documents. You can create or upload your own template by choosing Start from Blank option, but today we will use a pre-made purchase order template from our library and populate with data from SharePoint list. As you can see, our template library has many options that you can use as is or customize it. Let's give a name to our process. After clicking Next, we are redirected to the process editor. We can edit the template, test it, and download it. Here we can see tokens that are special placeholders enclosed in double curly brackets, and they will dynamically be replaced by data pulled from SharePoint. The template already has formulas that will calculate total cost per product as well as grand total for the whole purchase order. We have updated the template with our company information. Click Save and Next. In the Process Settings menu, we can switch the template mode to active or remain in testing. Next, we can include PO number and date in the file name as tokens, so they are added automatically. Next, choose PDF as the output format. There's an option to add a watermark to your PDF, and we can protect it with a password if you want to include sensitive information. There are also more advanced settings. Click Save and Next to proceed to creating a delivery process. We will use SharePoint Delivery to save all output documents in the SharePoint document library. However, you can choose a different or additional delivery method. For example, a created purchase order PDF can be automatically emailed to a customer or your purchasing department. Here we need to paste our SharePoint site address and click Connect. If this is your first time connecting your SharePoint site, you will need to add in your login and password. Next, we need to choose the library where the final PDF will be saved and create a folder name. Before we create a flow in PowerAutomate, we will use Plumsail Forms Designer tool for SharePoint that I mentioned earlier, and we'll customize the form. If you don't have Plumsail Forms Designer tool installed yet, you can go to your Plumsail account, click on Forms. Here on the right side, we can find step-by-step instructions. First, add a SharePoint tenant to your account. Second, add Plumsail app to the app catalog and enable it for all sites within your organization. And the final step is to install the designer, connect to SharePoint, and start customizing forms. We have opened our Forms Designer tool, and as you can see, the form is almost ready. We added tabs to better visualize our fields. We can add order date at the top of the form. This tool is extremely easy to use. You can just drag and drop from the list of containers, SharePoint fields, and controls. For example, we'll add data table control to the order info tab. Now we can customize the data table. Something important to note, name of the column needs to match the token in the PDF template we customized earlier. This is crucial to make sure that the correct data is pulled from SharePoint into our PDF file. However, a title can be different if you wish. Next important step is to save the data table control to the field in our SharePoint list. Click Save To and select the needed field. In our case, we'll save it to the products. Now let's check the form one more time. We have all our fields from the SharePoint as well as the data table. Now we can save it to SharePoint. The form was successfully saved, so now let's go back and check. We are back in SharePoint and we can see how different our form looks now. Let's create a new purchase order. Click Save. And as you can see, now we have a data table with products in the products field. which we're able to add with the help of Plumsail Forms Designer tool, as the default SharePoint form doesn't have this feature. And now our next and final step is to create a flow in PowerAutomate to convert SharePoint list items to PDF. We open Microsoft PowerAutomate and we will create a manual flow. Click My Flows, then New Flow, select Instant Cloud Flow, then give a name to your process and select Manually Trigger a Flow. Click Create. Now let's add a Get Items action. It will get all items from our SharePoint list. We need to add the SharePoint site we worked with earlier and select the list. There are other advanced options that you can choose from, for example, a filter query. Next, we need to find the Plumsail Documents connector so we can add an action called Start Document Generation Process with JSON. It will run the process we created and populate the template with data from SharePoint. If this is your first time connecting Plumsail Documents and PowerAutomate, you will need to establish a connection by creating an API key in your Plumsail account. First, go back to Plumsail Documents, click API key, create a name for it, and the key combination will be auto-generated. Next, click Copy and go back to PowerAutomate. Type the connection name you created and paste the key. Click Create. You're all set. Now we need to choose the purchase order process that we have created earlier in our Plumsail account. In the template data field, we need to enter the data in JSON format, and important, we need to match tokens from the PDF template with the fields in SharePoint list. If your SharePoint list contains an array of data, you will need to convert the data from string to array using an expression in PowerAutomate. For example, our list has a products column that contains a collection of products and details about them. So we click on expression and paste it to convert string into JSON. Let's check for typos. All looks good, and we can save this flow. Next, we go back to My Flows and let's run it. Now let's go back to SharePoint. We already have a new entry in the purchase order list, so let's check if it was successfully converted into a PDF. We click on Documents, and we can see there's a new folder with a PDF. The completed document looks great. Drop us a comment below on how you like to use SharePoint and PowerAutomate in your daily workflows, or if you have any questions, and we'll make sure to cover them in our future videos. And if you haven't tried Plumsail Documents and Forms yet, we have a free 30-day trial that gives you access to all the features, so you can explore new ways to upgrade your SharePoint forms or cut down time and effort on those tedious tasks with the help of automation. Thank you.